Welcome back to Yankees Hot Stove. I'm Meredith Marakovitz alongside Zack Britton. Zack, the 2020 season has come and gone. When you look back at 2020, what comes to mind?
A lot of things. Basically, just the fact that kind of shocked that we got through it all. I thought we did a great job as an organization, keeping everybody, as safe as we possibly could. But fortunate to get through the season. Obviously, we wanted to win the World Series, but considering the circumstances, I think overall, guys handled it, the situation really well.
Was it difficult to focus on the baseball side of it with everything else going on around you?
Yeah, there was so many things every day that we were trying to accomplish, without even playing the game. So it was difficult every day, especially when we were going through some situations where games were getting canceled because of, positive tests on other teams and the scheduling aspect and the starting and stopping for some guys too. I think it was really hard for a lot of guys to get into a pretty, consistent routine. So it was difficult, and hopefully, next year things will go smoother.
Can you describe how crazy it was for you as the player rep trying to get things going and then maintain contact throughout the course of the season to keep everything running smoothly?
Yeah, I mean, I was, constantly on the phone, whether it was with, teammates or with the Players Association or even Brian Cashman, just, all the information that we were getting, we were trying to relay to each other and just keep things running smoothly. Like I said, I think the Yankees did a great job from top to bottom. Obviously Hal giving us the resources above and beyond of what they had to keep us, in a good frame of mind, whether it's at the hotel, at the field, things like that. A lot of phone time. The first thing I did when I got home was put the phone away for a little bit.
You mentioned getting home. You said towards the end of the season, it was a mental grind for you due to the fact that you weren't able to see your family essentially the entire season. What was it like when you walked in your door and saw your kiddos for the first time in a long time?
I thought they're gonna be like excited to see me, run to me. I mean, they were excited, right? But they're in their own little world right now. For me though, it was nice. Could kind of take a breath a little bit. Good to see my wife and the kids, and just being a family again, being around everybody is something that I missed throughout the season. One of the aspects I think you forget during the year is, there's obviously ups and downs through the course of a long season, and it's nice to be able to go home and vent to your wife or just to see your kids. And when you don't have that, I found obviously I got some good relationships with my teammates, obviously communicating that way. And maybe talking to them about some more personal things that you normally wouldn't, but I miss that aspect of having the family there when I got home after games.
Have there been any discussions amongst your teammates or even with the Players Association as far as what might happen in 2021?
No, we haven't had those talks yet. I know we have some union meetings coming up sometime in December, and I'm not sure if the union and we have talked yet about what next season's going to look like. I think they're still waiting for some things on a national level to kind of get ironed out, and then we'll go from there. But I'm sure we'll have an idea, well before spring training's supposed to start.
Do you think it'll be a full season next year?
I'm not sure. I would never, after everything that we went through, I would never put in, my word or my name to anything at this stage. I have no idea. I'm hopeful that we can play, 162 games with a regular spring training and that the world's back to normal. So, we all can do that. But I think we're prepared for, any situation, any scenario that comes up at this stage. You can never be too certain at this stage in the year.
End of October, the Yankees picked up your option. You'll be there in the 2021 season, 2022 season. Was there any doubt in your mind that they were going to exercise that option?
There definitely was. Due to obviously financial situations that teams are in, from what they're saying. I didn't know. Me and my agent, Scott Boris, we really hadn't discussed in great length, like what's going to happen if they didn't and what we wanted to do in regards to free agency and things like that. So it was nice, obviously, to get that call from Cash and talk to him about it. And obviously, I'm excited to stay in New York for the next 2 years and, hopefully win a championship. It's the reason why I came here in the first place. So to have two more years to kind of realize that that goal would be nice.
you've had success on the mound since coming to the Yankees. Your sinker last year seemed to drop a little bit more than years past. Did you change something to get that extra drop on the sinker?
No, I mean, that's a good observation, though, because through, you know, the analytics and stuff like that, especially the postseason, I had I definitely had increased the movement on my sinker. They say the depth of it, so the way that it's going down. Very similar to some of the years, the really good years I had in Baltimore. There was actually a couple things, you know, talking with, you know, Brett McCabe, who we brought over, obviously, this year, Eric Cressy, Matt Blake, and, you know, Mike Harkey, just talking to them about something with my stride that I felt like was getting more natural. You know, obviously, I had that Achilles injury a few years ago, but you lose some type of feel in your delivery when that happens to you and you go through a surgery like that. And I was able to find something that was familiar in my delivery, in my stride, kind of shortening my stride, I guess is the best way to describe it. Shortening my stride back to the length that it was in Baltimore, it allowed me to get on top of the ball and pull down a little bit more on my sinker, which caused, you know, a good amount of like increase in drop that I had had before that maybe I had lost a little bit. So that's good going into next year, you know, that I know what that feels like now, and I'm able to, you know, watch video and get the data to support it, which is nice too.